Hey, Robert Murray here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a navbar in your GroovePages account, either using the internal navbar or making your own, and also show you how to add and hide your pages from that navbar. And also, in a moment, I'll show you how to get my $2,000 worth of bonuses just for grabbing a free GroovePages account. So cue the intro. Okay, so I'm in my GroovePages, GrooveFunnels account now, so I'll go into GroovePages, and I'm just going to add a new site, and let's just use a blank template. And yeah, few of you have asked in my YouTube channel how you do create navbars, how do you add the pages, etc. So I'm just going to add a wireframe empty block here. Oh, there you go. Took a little while. So there's a few different ways you can do it. You can make your own navbar, or you can come into blocks in here and go into, in fact, if I go into designed blocks and you've got navigation bars here. So let's say we wanted to use this one. So I didn't really need to drag the block in there, but we could do the same. We can replicate this. So let's see how many it's got. So it's got a logo over here. It's got the pages will show up in the middle. And then you've got three over here. So what's that, five? So if I want to add a five column row in here, I didn't let go at the right time. Let me do that again. Boom. And then I could add an image over here. If I could actually drop it at the right place. And then I could add pages in here. So I could add the little nav thing in here now. In fact, you know, I'm just going to scrap that completely. We'll just work with the actual nav bar. So first things first, this shows here because in pages, this page is called home. Now, if I add an additional page, and let's say I call it about us, or you can edit the settings here. Let's say about, and let's call it about there for the URL, and then click save. When we now go back to the home, you can see that it's added the two pages. So again, if I add another page, let's call it contact us, edit the settings, just call it contact. And then save, and then the same thing. So you can see now it's adding those as we go. Now, if I want to hide that from the navbar, if let's say I'm building out a new page, and let's say it's a funnel page, let's go to templates, and let's just grab any, what we got? There we go, let's use that. Just an ebook landing page. So now let's say we call that one landing page. Okay, oh sorry, needs a dash. So let's say now, if we go back to our home, I don't want that showing there, it just looks strange. I might have a hyperlink somewhere in the website where I have that. So all I need to do is drag this down below here. So see how it's got hidden pages now? So I can still work in that page is still live, and that page will be off of that link that I set up there. So you can see here it would be /landing pages, but in the main home page of this website it's now disappeared, which is really cool. So now I can just come in here and edit this as at my convenience. I can add my logo if I want there, put that one there and click update, and it doesn't show very well on that white background, but we'll do that in a moment. I'm going to just size it by coming down to PX. So choosing and sizing the PX, and then now I can drag the scroller. I don't want it too big. And also I want some spacing, or I don't want spacing above and below, but I'll work on that in a second. I think I'm actually going to change the background color. So I'll go here and let's just change that to white, which means my logo will show up better. And then I'll need to click into this as well, which is the nav menu, and change the background there as well, but I need to change the text first. Let's change that to black and then the background to white. Okay, and also these icons over here are in white, so I need to change the color of those. So we'll look, configure. And update, it should. Oh, okay, it's just changed. What one was that one? Let me preview, because I haven't saved it, so it might, oh no, it's already updated. So let's try and see. There's one there, let me see what it was. Yeah, it doesn't, when you click into it, it doesn't tell you that it was Facebook or, but that's fine. We can just say Facebook, it should pop up. Let's use that one as Facebook. Let's change the color there to black. And then you've always got to click update. Okay, I don't know if I clicked on it properly. Let's go with that one. It takes a second. Facebook update, boom. So let's change this one now to, it probably was Twitter or something. Twitter, that one's fine. Give it a second, click update. Update, boom. And then the third one, probably Instagram or something, I'm guessing. Doesn't matter, and obviously these would just be the ones that you want to show. Let's go for that one. And you can see it takes a second for it to kind of populate. So you just got to be a little bit patient with it, and then click update, and that should now save. So there you go. So we've now got our nav bar. So let's go into the setting, because I'm not happy with the spacing above and below. Let's see, yeah, so we've got some spacing above and below there. Just want to reduce that down. It's just wasted space above the fold. Maybe about there, looks okay. Seems all right. So now what I would do is I would create a global style, or I know you can't save, let me click in the block. I can save the block as a favorite. And then it means that when I go to my other pages, so I'm gonna go to nav bars here, navigation bars, save, and then save. So now it makes it easy for me to add this to my other pages. So if I pop in here and go to about, the first thing I need to add is that navbar block. And you can pretty much see, which one was it? That one there, I think. Drag it in and drop, boom. Save, and then do the same thing with the other pages. So contact, blocks, navbar, that one there. So you can do the same thing obviously with a footer. If you're putting a footer across every page in your website, you just do the same thing, modify it till the point where you're happy. Obviously I didn't even add the links in here, so I could add the hyperlink to my Twitter, etc. So you come down here and click URL and then paste in the URL, but I'm not gonna do that because I just there's no need. So yeah, I hope that makes sense. So now on our home bar, let's say just we wanted to add a block. Let's just drag in something like that. This is just one of the blocks off of my old website that hasn't added the background color, which is very strange. Ah, there it is. It just took a little, it might be my internet today. So now you can see that makes the footer or the header pop. The other thing you can do with the nav bar now, I'm trying to remember how we did it before, but you can have the nav bar. So if I show you over here, if I start scrolling, the nav bar disappears. But you can have it so the nav bar stays at the top if you want. I'm just trying to remember how. Ah, that was right. That was right. There'll be a video which will connect to this. Let me just go back to my sheet. We did do one. It's a little bit of code you need to add. So there's no point in me going into that now. But what we'll do is we'll up above me now, you'll be able to see the link that you can click to go and see how to make that nav bar stay at the top. So that's pretty much it. So Again, grab my $2,000 worth of bonuses down below and it'll be popping up on the screen right now. That's just for signing up for a free GroovePages account. Then over here on the left, there'll be some additional videos you can watch, and make sure you subscribe and click the bell because we're doing lots of training tutorials. And also comment and like down below. Let me know what other videos I can do for you. We're doing sort of one a day at the moment. So that's it from me, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye for now.